Hello students, this is Dr. Shilpa Kapoor from Oriental College of Technology, Bhopal, Madhya Pradesh. The topic of my video is Properties of Nucleus. Brief flow of presentation. Introduction, classification of nuclei, general properties of nucleus, binding energy. Now, introduction. The atomic nucleus is composed of protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons within the nucleus are called the nucleons. In the figure, we have shown the protons and neutrons are nucleus, which contains neutrons and protons. The protons is shown by blue ball and neutron is shown by the red ball. A proton has positive charge of the same magnitude as that of the electron and its red mass is about 186 times the mass of an electron. A neutron is electrically neutral whose mass is almost equal to the mass of the proton. A nucleus of an element is represented as ZXA, where X is the chemical symbol of the element. Z represents the atomic number, which is equal to the number of protons or electrons, and A is the mass number, which is equal to the sum of the proton and neutrons. The number of neutrons is represented as capital N, which is equal to A minus Z. For example, the chlorine nucleus is represented as 17 chlorine 35. It contains 17 protons and 18 neutrons. The copper nucleus is represented as 19 Cu 63. It contains 29 protons and 34 neutrons. As we go from the higher nuclei, we can see that the number of neutrons is always more than the number of protons. So why do the neutrons outnumber protons in heavier nuclei? For this, we have to understand the two type of forces. The first is the long-range electrostatic force that makes the positively charged particles repel one another, as shown in the figure A. And the second is a short-range nuclear force, which are attractive force that makes all the neutrons in the nucleus attract one another, as shown in the figure B. Classification of nuclei. The nuclei are classified in three categories. First is isotopes, second is isobars, and third is isotones. Isotopes are the atoms of same element having the same atomic number Z but different mass number A. For example, the nuclei 1H1, which is hydrogen, 1H2, which is deuterium, and 1H3 are also the isotopes of the hydrogen. Now, isobars. Isobars are the atoms of different elements having the same mass number A but different atomic number Z. For example, the nuclei oxygen and nitrogen. Here, the mass number of the nitrogen and oxygen is same. That's why they are the isobars. The third category is the isotones. Isotones are the atoms of different elements having the same number of neutrons. For example, 6 carbon 14 and oxygen 16 are the example of isotones. We can understand this by also this. For example, if we count the number of neutrons in the carbon 14, so the 14 minus 6 is equals to 8. The number of neutrons are 8. And in the example of oxygen, when we subtract 8 from 16, we get 8. That is, we get the same number of neutrons. That's why they are the example of the isotones. General properties of nucleus. The general properties of nucleus are the nuclear size, nuclear density, nuclear charge, and nuclear mass. Nuclear size. According to the Rutherford's particle scattering experiment, the radius of the nucleus R and its mass number is given by R is proportional to A to the power 1 by 3. R is equals to R0 A to the power 1 by 3, where R0 is the constant proportionality and is equals to 1.4 Fermi, where 1 fermi is equals to 10 to the power minus 15 meter. Nuclear density. The nuclear density can be calculated from the mass and the size of the nucleus. The nuclear density can be represented as rho n, which is equals to nuclear mass upon nuclear volume. The nuclear mass, capital M, is equals to A into Mn, where A is the mass number and Mn is the mass of one nucleon and is approximately equal to the 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. As the nucleus is spherically, the shape of the nucleus is spherical, so the nuclear volume is equals to the volume of the sphere, which is equals to 4 upon 3 pi r cube. So we can write the nuclear density as M, capital M upon 4 upon 3 pi r cube. The nuclear density is calculated as 1.816 into 10 to the power 17 kg per meter cube. The high value of the nuclear density shows that the nuclear matter is in an extremely compressed state. Next is the nuclear charge. The charge of the nucleus is due to the protons present in it. Each proton has a positive charge, which is equals to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. The nuclear charge is equals to Ze, which is where Z is the atomic number. Now the nuclear mass. The nucleus contains the protons and neutrons. The assumed nuclear mass is equals to Z into Mp plus A minus Z Mn, where Z is the atomic number, A minus Z is the number of neutrons. Or we can say Z is equals to the number of protons. Here Mp is the mass of proton and Mn is the mass of neutron. It is always found that the stable nucleus and the mass of the stable nucleus is always less than the total number of nucleons. So we can say that if the mass of the stable nucleus is capital M, which is less than the mass of the nucleons. So if we subtract them, then we get the mass defect, that which is equals to del M. Del M is equals to ZMP plus N. N equals to A minus Z, which is number of neutrons, into Mn minus M. Thus, the difference in the total mass of the nucleons and the actual mass of the nucleus is known as the mass defect. Binding energy. When the protons and neutrons combine to form a nucleus, the mass that appears is converted into an equivalent amount of energy. This energy is called the binding energy of the nucleus. Another definition of the binding energy is that the energy which binds the nucleons in the nucleus is called the binding energy. The formula of binding energy is equals to del m c square, where del m is the mass defect, which is equals to Zmp plus A minus Z Mn minus M. And the binding energy is equals to del m c square. The binding energy determines the stability against disintegration. If the binding energy is large, the nucleus is stable. The binding energy per nucleon varies from element to element. The figure shows the binding energy graph. From the binding energy graph, we can see that the binding energy per nucleon increases sharply with the mass number A up to 20. It increases slowly after A equals to 20. For mass number is less than 20, we can see that in the figure there exist recurrence of peaks corresponding to those nuclei whose mass numbers are multiples of 4, and they contain not only equal but also even number of the protons and neutrons. For example, if in the case of we can see in the case of the helium, beryllium, carbon, oxygen and neon. From the figure, we can also see that the curve becomes almost flat for the mass number between 40 to 120. Beyond 120, it decreases slowly as mass number increases. Here in the figure, we have seen a dotted line. Here the binding energy पर न्यूक्लियॉन रीचेस द मैक्सिमम. द बाइंडिंग एनर्जी पर न्यूक्लियॉन रीचेस द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ मेगा इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट एट द मास नंबर ए इक्वल्स टू 56 कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग टू द आयरन न्यूक्लियस. हेंस वी कैन से डैट द आयरन न्यूक्लियस इज द मोस्ट स्टेबल न्यूक्लियस. From this we can also read that the average binding energy per nucleon is about 8.5 mega electron volt for the nuclei having the mass number ranging from 40 to 120. These elements are comparatively more stable and non-radioactive. For the higher mass numbers, the curve drops slowly and the binding energy per nucleon is about 7.6 mega electron volt for the uranium. Hence, they are the unstable and radioactive. Lesser the amount of the binding energy for the lighter and heavy nuclei explain the process of fission and fusion respectively. A large amount of energy will be liberated if the lighter nuclei fused to form a heavier nuclear one, which is the fission, or if the heavier nuclei are split into the lighter nuclear ones, which is the fission. Thanks.